Airbnb hosts are panic selling everything. And I don't blame them. Looking at this chart, they just went from 600,000 all the way down to 100,000. And I've owned Airbnb units, so I know the pain. And this comes right out of Wall Street Journal, which I'm too cheap to pay for. And there's been a flood of people. You have people coming into us saying, I'm a month or two away from foreclosure. What's it going to take to get this sold now? And pending home sales plummet by 20% in March. Wait till we see April. And Goldman Sachs says mid-2020, highly likely we're going to have another market crash like we did on Black Thursday. So we are not out of this shaft just yet. Did he just say shaft? Yes, elevator shaft, you sick, twisted kids. And like always on this channel, if I can get you to like one time, I get you to like, get you to laugh. When you laugh, you click the like. I'm just asking. It really helps out the YouTube algorithms. We need that around here. But if you like channels that have to do with business and making money, and then with your business, what do? That money, we invest it in things like Bitcoin. Hey, how about that? 8,500. That thing has some rocket boosters on it. So if you could just at least consider, you don't have to just yet. Just wait. I may, you know, like a virus, it kind of grow on you. And then later on, you're like, all right, I think I'll subscribe. And GDP falls off another cliff. Everything just is like little lemmings falling off cliffs. Another almost 5%, 4.9%. For you little people in my audience that have to be right, you know, like, oh, you missed it by a percent, what, 0.001? So this chart comes from AirDNA. If you guys have rental properties, they'll give you like the deep dive on everything. And they have a team of people that will help draw arrows just in case you get lost on what direction your money is going. And I went ahead and helped their team out. For next month, in March, I drew them a toilet bowl for everyone's money to go directly into the blue water of the toilet bowl. Remember, kids, to always close that lid because you never know after you flush. I'm going to tell you something kind of gross, but you know when you go into a bathroom and you smell something? Well, those particles are actually inserting themselves inside your nose. I am so sorry, but I just think you came here to get educated. So you're not actually just smelling it, you're eating it too. So coming to you from the Wall Street Journal, which Johnny Bravo is too cheap to pay the 20 bucks a month. I do not know how I was able to get onto the site. And hey, look, the S&P 500's up 2.5%. The Dow is up. What, did they cure the virus? A bargain with the devil. Bill comes due for overextended Airbnb host entrepreneurs, built many empires, and you guys are going to trip at this, on how many people own one, own two, and then own 25, of short-term rental properties borrowing against revenue that has now vanished. Not vanishing, vanished. And there's a quick lesson in business, kids. When you leverage, when you decide to buy Bitcoin at 100 times leverage or whatever, that's, you're just 100 times stupider. But these people have leveraged everything that they got. They're like, oh, I'm making an extra, you know, 20 grand a month, 30 grand a month. Well, yeah, until when? And I'll tell you, corporations, governments, don't look too kindly at Airbnb. So don't be thinking that you're getting any bailout anytime soon. I mean, unless your Airbnb is on a cruise ship or something, or, you know, your last name's Hilton, I don't think you're getting nothing. And I like it. It's called free market. You fail, and when you get wiped out, I come in, and then I buy it. Which, let's see how this plays out over the next 6 months. You guys might have a lot of money to be made from people that decided to risk their mini empires. And in the story, Cheryl was making $8,000 a month from Airbnb, which is double what you just normally, you know, rent out a property and you can't get it rented and blah, blah, blah. I mean, 8,000 bucks is a lot of cheddar. And now she's going from some sick cheddar to getting some mold on that cheese. She now has $22,000 a month in expenses. And sometimes you just gotta sit back and when you look at investments, you look at properties, you look at owning stocks, whatever it is, and go, is the squeeze worth the juice? Sometimes it is, sometimes it's not, and you can't really put a stop loss on this like you can in the stock market, which is nice. You know, you make your trade, you put in a little stop so you can stop losing money. Airbnb, oh no, you just run to a broker and be like, sell all. And looking at this chart over here to the left, February, 577,000, almost 600,000, I'll round it. I don't understand this chart because it does not have a directional arrow, so we will just continue on. And the story says the sharing economy has proven particularly unstable in this bad word that we cannot use on the tubes. But also you have to think of it this way. Right now, yeah, super unstable. And then when, you know, the virus comes for the second time, right? Everyone's like, oh, the numbers are getting too high, and there it goes again. And for me, I'm kind of the guy that shoots first, aim later, you know, and then kind of go like, oh, all right. I think this one, you may want to wait this one out before you jump into buying some Airbnb properties. I think time is on your side. Time is of the essence. I don't know why time would be of the essence. I have to Wikipedia this one. Is a term used in contract law in England and Wales. So you see, on this channel, guys, we learn together. And to pour salt packets on the womb, hosts should have always been prepared for this economy to go away, says Gina, principal at Argentina Group, which does credit risk analysis for real estate loans. Instead, they built their expensive lifestyle and feeding off of it. But Gina, I just want to say, like, how are these people supposed to know that there is going to be a pandemic? Like, let's just make sure that we prepare for a 100-year pandemic where all of our sales go to zero. And this statement is for the record books. Holy God, we're about to lose everything. Oh, so you're going to pray now rather than before. And just maybe you should have prayed, holy God, should we leverage 30 properties so we could make some mad cheddar? And holy God would say, no, I think Mrs. Dupe, you should hold off until you get some kind of insurance policy to protect you. And here is the chart that just freaked me out. Not so much this chart of 455%. Or 320% by host, it's this right here. It's this sentence made my neck snap back a little bit. AirDNA, that was that site I talked to you about, estimates that one third, I'll even draw you a little pie chart of one third. I had to think about that one for a second on the one third thing. Let me fix the, oh gosh, what is that line? All you OCDers are just gonna go crazy with that. Oh, or does me drawing outside the line over here make you a little crazier? So I think I fixed it, but now this thing is going to drive you crazy. Anyways, okay, so they estimate that one third of everyone on Airbnb owns one property. And then another third, they own somewhere between 2 and 24. That's a big difference, right? But if you're a statistical guy, let's just go right in the middle, own 12. But it's this one down here that just really made my head snap back. I'm telling you, a third of Airbnb is, these people own 25 plus units. And they're all doing like what we did last month in the stock market and just like, sell, sell all, I don't care. Well, Bob, Bitcoin's connected to your sell, but I don't care. Go, it all goes. All right, guys, so real quick, I just got interrupted by my daughter. Can you, hold on, let's see if you can see her. Oh, this is such a terrible picture. Does it have your number on here? No, does it? No. Okay, all right, so please tell my audience how much that you are making by sitting on your boo-hole hole and doing nothing rather than babysitting.
Well, thanks to Gavin Newsom, I get $600 a week plus my unemployment. So I'm making around $2,700 a month for sitting on my butt.
All right. Thanks, sweetie. Love you.
Love you. Bye.
Bye. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. And the emoji that we need for this one is a big facepalm. And more stories that sound a lot alike is the 47-year-old expected to net up to $7,000 a month. I want to net up to $7,000 a month from Airbnb after mortgage payments, supplementing her income as a part-time pharmacist. So part-time drug dealer and her husband as a school teacher. Okay. Before the cough struck, the couple was considering buying more homes. Now they can't make mortgage payments because no one is booking. And let me move this out of my shirt so you can see it. Here's the word we're looking for. We're either borrowing more or we are defaulting. Think about that. We have people that are doctors, school teachers, combined incomes of a lot of money. that are going to default.
And then blah, 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 how the government says that they're not going to bail them out. Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac. That's where you can, what, go 3 months without having to pay. Be very careful on those guys that they say, yeah, don't worry about it. You can pay us back, you know, all of it at the end of 4 months. Otherwise, we're just going to destroy your credit. And here is, it looks like Jennifer taking pictures because she's going to, as she says, it's scary, says Airbnb host Jennifer, of the current climate. Here shopping for rental unit furnishings and decor. I would say, Jennifer, you probably shouldn't. And then last but not least, to summarize, here it is right here. She began shutting down her Airbnb account. She said, I don't want to bargain with the devil anymore. And I'd have to agree with her. For me, I'm not the kind of guy that goes all in. A little bit, you know, is the juice worth the squeeze? Okay, just a little bit over here, a little bit over there. I'm not like all in on gold, all in on Bitcoin. We're going to leverage our house and just run with it. You know, let it ride. At some point, the house wins. And since you guys just love charts and more charts, the GDP, gross domestic pixie dust, is down almost 5%, the lowest since 2008, or almost the lowest. That would be the lowest right there. So just give us one more month of GDP, and let's see if we can beat it. And then U.S. new one family home house sold annually, monthly. We're also down on that one. Almost there. We almost beat 2013. Down 15.4%. The only time you want to be down 15.4% is in body fat. And here's another important chart. If you like balls of yarn, here it is again, 15.4%. The lowest. March has been the worst. And some more charts about new one-family homes, existing and pending. All basically summarized as I told you so. And then total new home sales in 000 versus median new home sales price. And again, yeah, it's not falling off a cliff. Yeah, it's falling off a cliff. And then coming in from Goldman, chilling S&P 500 crash prediction makes Bitcoin vulnerable in mid-2020. I would have to agree. The S&P and Bitcoin have been mirroring each other over the last, I'd say, 3 months. And then they're kind of expecting this little bounce, aka dead cat bounce. One more bounce, and then, yeah, I guess we're back off to the races again by the end of the year. So this is your logical call, just like what they're saying, that we're going to dip down. A lot of analysts are saying that we're actually going to take out this low. I say, based on the big F word, and trillions of dollars got to go someplace, and it's probably not going to be the housing market. It's going to be the stock market. And right now, the S&P is up 3%. NASDAQ is almost grabbing 4%. And crude oil up almost 15%. Like how I do that, I round. I could say 14, but that's a 0.5. Got to round. And gold is flat at 1,706. Unless you want to buy the real gold, then it is real and you pay a real price rather than a derivative price. And holy mother front door, Bitcoin almost hits 9,000 on a sweet pump. And on this channel, I teach you how to trade. Although it's not financial advice, don't ever listen to me. You lose 1,000% of your money. This is TradingView on the 4 hour. And how you would make this trade, you have swings. I'm a swing trader. I'm not a buy and hodler. So on this one, it swings down, it's up. One candle up, you can put it there, anywhere of these, and you just hold it until it goes below the 20, and as you can see, it just nips it. It's like, nope, and then here you go. You may lose little trades here and there, little ones, you know, you lose, but when you win pretty darn big. It kind of makes up for all the losses. So on this one, you would be up about 28% if you're a greedy, savage trader, and you're like, I don't want it to go below that line. I'm cashing out now. 28% is enough for me. Also, I'll leave a link in the description below. My buddy Charlie has a course on it. I think if there are things that you need to learn in life, number one is learn how to trade equities. Get a game plan, how to enter, how to exit. Link in the description on that one. Number two is start a business. That's what I do, and I've done that for decades. Even have a course on it. Link in the description. I offer 3 codes. They go pretty darn fast. So snap them up. while the goodies are hot. But be safe out there, guys. Be careful of the FOMO. That's fear of missing out. They start to see this and they're like, oh, leverage our house. No, you wait until it does what you want it to do. You tell the market. This is not the market telling you. You do what you do and stick to a plan. And I'll see you tomorrow.